Welcome back to our channel, and I'm going to start off by moisturizing like always using my Lubriderm Extra Dry Advanced Therapy Lotion.
Hey guys, so I kind of wanted to take a second and talk about something. I'm really not the type of person to bash a product or bash a company, but when I figured this out, it really kind of upset me. And I'm talking about the e.l.f. Mineral Infused Primer. Are you guys seeing that I have been using this my past like three videos that I posted up? This is the first primer that I've ever used, and I wanted to buy a drugstore primer to see if I liked it before I invested and spent more money into in a higher end product. So I wasn't using this every day when I first got it, but then I started to because it really does make a difference when I'm putting on my foundation, and it really makes my foundation look really like airbrushed. So I started using it every day, and about maybe 2.5 weeks ago, I realized that I don't have any. I'm there and I'm like trying to pump it out and there's nothing coming out. So I'm like, okay, maybe I just, because I use a lot of primer when I'm applying it. I apply it basically all over my face. So I'm like, okay, I'll take the end of like a makeup brush, like an eyeshadow brush or something, and I open it. So I'm like, I'll like try and like dig out more product. So when I do that, literally this is how much of the brush goes in, just that much. So what that means is basically this whole like frosty container here, there's absolutely no product in there. Absolutely none. The only product that you're paying for is this little container, this little section right here. There's a separate container of product that's halfway full. So I paid, I think, somewhere between like $5 or $6 for this. I mean, compared to high-end products, this is really, you know, affordable and not expensive. But I was under the assumption that there is product in this whole frosty container, and there's none. It's just product in this little separate container right here. I like the primer, but just for the simple fact that I'm paying $5-$6 for this much product, I probably am not going to repurchase this, because I feel like it's like the company kind of like took advantage of their customers. They're kind of like tricking us, and I just didn't like it. So if you guys want or are looking for a drugstore primer, please don't buy this. Please don't waste your money and buy it, because you're spending $5-$6 for this much primer. I am on the lookout for a better drugstore primer, so when I do find one, I am going to let you guys know. But enough of me rambling.
And moving on from that little rant, I did purchase the Beauty Blogger Darlings set, and I'm going to prime using the Too Faced Poreless Skin Smoothing Face Primer. Now, I did purchase the Too Faced Born This Way foundation, and I'm in the color Honey. I'm just going to dot this all over my face and blend it out with a Real Techniques sponge. And I'm just going to set that with my MAC Studio Fix powder, and of course I'm in the shade NC45. Using my Too Faced Insurance eyeshadow primer, I'm just going to prime my eyelids, and then I'm going to apply tape on the very end of my eye just to make sure I have that sharp, clean line. Going in with this shade right here, this is my Sephora Wonderland palette, and I'm just going to apply this into the crease and upper crease. I'm focusing this color mostly in the upper crease and blending it up to my brow bone. Don't try to change me in any way. for stay. Now I'm going to take a mixture of these two purple pinkish shade, and with a small detailed crease brush from MAC, I am going to place this directly into the crease. Now you see I'm continuously adding more product, and I'm going to build up the intensity to what I want. Right now I'm applying a black eyeshadow to the outer V, and I'm going to continuously pick up more of the black, blend, pick up more, and blend until I like the way that it looks. She's the one, smoke with her until the stand up until we see the sun and baddest ever. Now for the lip color, I'm going to go into my Carly Bible palette and pick up those two goldish shades in her palette, and I'm applying this all over the lip. And I'm going to take the edge of my brush and just flick it out to the end just so I can blend it. Now again, of course, I'm going to be adding on more black. Now for eyeliner, of course, I'm going to be using my e.l.f. cream liner. Now, I don't hate e.l.f., but the primer just kind of pissed me off a little bit, but I do love their eyeliner. For lashes, I'm going with the Ardell Demi Wispies. I did that off camera. And for the brow bone, I'm just applying that light shade color right there. Now I did apply black liner to my waterline, but now I'm just going to apply that black eyeshadow to my lower lash line and then take a mixture of all three of those pink shades and blend out that black shadow. Now I'm going in with the Too Faced Deluxe Chocolate Soleil Matte Bronzer and just going to warm up my face and bring some life back into it. And I can always have just what I want. Now for mascara, I'm using the Too Faced Better Than Sex Mascara, and I'm just going to apply this on my top and bottom lashes. For blush, I'm using the La Bella Zona in Andrea. You guys know I love this blush. I'm going to take my high beam, and I'm just going to apply this on the places that I would normally apply highlight, and then I'm going to set that with two mixtures in my Carly Bible palette. You're seeing it right now. I'm just going to take out my Real Techniques sponge and blend in that highlight just so it can blend more seamlessly into my face. Now for lips, I'm using the NYX Liquid Suede, and this is in the color Sandstorm. And in the clip soon, I'm just going to show you guys an up close of the eye look just so you guys can see it. And this is going to be the end of the look, guys. I hope you guys like it. And please don't forget to subscribe and like the video if you do.